To better understand video game technology, it's important to understand common settings and terms. Let's explore some video game graphics settings and related terms and describe what those settings do. Game performance is typically measured in frames per second, or FPS for short. FPS represents the number of consecutive images displayed on your screen every second. For example, 30 FPS means that the screen displays 30 frames every second. A game performing with a high FPS will look and feel smooth. But if the FPS drops too low, game animations, player movement, and interactions can become sluggish and choppy. The ideal value for FPS today is 60 due to most readily available monitors and TVs having 60Hz refresh rates, meaning they are optimized to display 60 frames per second. Resolution is the number of unique pixels that make up a monitor screen. Most games will include a resolution setting that is typically set to match your monitor's native resolution. However, this setting can be changed to something other than native resolution, impacting game performance and visual quality. Enabling the VSync setting ensures that each frame rendered by the game lines up with your monitor's refresh rate. VSync can help minimize or remove issues like screen tearing, but can sometimes introduce visual stuttering or input lag. Many games have a general quality preset setting, which affects the overall graphics quality by adjusting several settings at once. This is useful when trying to quickly establish the game settings that work best for your computer. After choosing a preset, you can then fine-tune individual settings to further dial in quality and performance. Some games have a setting that controls level of detail or far object detail. This refers to the distance from your point of view that high-quality objects will be replaced with lower detail objects. Lowering these settings can increase performance at the cost of visual quality by increasing the number of simple objects displayed in the game. The texture resolution setting adjusts the quality of the images that are drawn on the surface of objects in the game. Lowering this setting can increase game performance by using less detailed images, while using higher texture settings will increase the quality of these images at the cost of reducing game performance. Texture filtering minimizes the distortion of textures on objects that are displayed at an oblique angle, making the images look sharper. This helps to display straight lines further into the distance before becoming blurry. Anti-aliasing helps to smooth the appearance of pixelated lines commonly seen on curved edges and angled lines. There are many different methods of anti-aliasing. Many games will allow you to choose which type to use, since some anti-aliasing methods impact game performance more than others. Shadow resolution settings control the quality of the shadows cast by objects in the game. Lowering this setting can increase game performance at the cost of rendering blockier, less detailed shadows. Screen space ambient occlusion, or SSAO, is a rendering technique used to simulate how bright lighting should be at different parts of a visible surface. SSAO helps to create richer, more realistic shadows, especially at contact points between multiple surfaces. Screen space reflections, or SSR, is a rendering technique that simulates reflections on the surface of objects using what is currently visible on screen. This technique helps the game to quickly process and display reflective surfaces, but it cannot reflect objects that are off-screen. Ray tracing is a more photorealistic way to achieve lighting, shadows, and reflections in video games. The advantage to ray tracing is that it is more accurate than older methods like screen space ambient occlusion and screen space reflections. For example, ray tracing can reflect objects that are off-screen, unlike screen space reflections. The disadvantages to ray tracing are that it requires hardware that specifically supports this feature, and it can be incredibly resource-intensive, significantly impacting game performance. This concludes our quick overview of some common video game graphics settings and related terms. For more information about this topic and your Lenovo devices, subscribe to Lenovo Support on YouTube or go to pcsupport.lenovo.com.